Bless the Lord. Good morning and welcome to worship. Wherever you've come from, wherever you're joining us from, we want to welcome you to our service of old songs and hymns of praise and worship. And already we have gotten off to a good start. And maybe there might even be opportunities for some of you to come and sing a song for us that we have never heard, but a song that means much to you. Because so often you hear a song and it brings back memories, and you stop and you think about it, and the words just fill you with a sense of love, memories, and joy, and remembering some family members and their faith, because you know our faith is rooted in our families and our communities. And it is good when we remember and reflect and give thanks. So it's going to be a great time. And now after we have finished, we're going to have some food together. Hope you've brought lots of food, because it's going to be an amazing time. But it's good to be back with you and to be in the presence of the Lord. And God is always good. Let me read some verses to you from Psalm 100. This is what the psalmist says in Psalm 100. He says, "Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness." Did you hear that? Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his, he says. We, he says, are the sheep of his pasture. Okay, I carry on here. We are the sheep of his pastures, he says. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. His courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name, he says. For the Lord is good and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. Let's take a moment just to reflect on that thought. It says, the Lord is good, and his faithfulness endures forever. We're going to continue as we sing that opening song. Will the group come and lead us in that opening song, please? As we sing this beautiful old hymn, "To God Be the Glory," I want you to think about something you want to thank God for and say, "I want to thank you for this. To God be the glory, great things he has done." Let's stand together. Let's take our seats for a moment. As most of you, if not all of you, are already aware that Maxine's father passed away some time ago. He's going to be buried on the 29th. And just this past week, my uncle, who I've asked you to pray for, he went home to be with his Lord. And so it is a challenging time. But even then, you can still say to God, be the glory. Because it is in these situations that you experience the reality of your faith and the presence of God, that God is good and God is able. Maxine and I arrived back this morning from our break, and there was a delay. But I just relaxed and said, Lord, everything is going to be fine. Everything is going to be fine. And here we are. Maxine is coming through anyway. In a minute, she's just doing a couple of things. And it's easy to say God is good when everything seems fine. But it is when you're in the midst of it. And you say, I knew that God did this. I couldn't have done it. God did this for me. And when things doesn't even seem to be going your way, yet it is important to be able to say, God is working his purposes out. And not only will he help me, but he will bring it through at the right time. He says, so loved he the world that he gave us his son. I wonder, how many of you has this hymn brought back some memories to? I'm not going to ask you what memories yet, because later on you can share that. How many of you, as you sung these words, it brought back memories of different experiences? Yeah. You say yes. You remember those times when you knew for sure that, Lord, I just want to praise you in this. And sisters and brothers, we're living in challenging times, but also opportune times, because it is in the challenge that we have the opportunity to make known our good God in every situation. But we have to be willing to trust him. To trust him and to walk with him. And also to remember, someone was saying to me recently that where they are worshiping at the moment, the minister was taking a different view to what he felt was the right view to take. And he wasn't quite sure as to whether or not he could continue being there. And I said to him that one of the most important things you have to ask God is, Lord, where do you want me to be? Because remember this, we're never always going to agree. But when we know where God wants us to be, we can work together. And when we seek God's will, we work out his purposes together. And I said, just imagine that, you know, God said, well, if you don't agree with me, I'm going to leave you. Do you think God will be here among us? God wouldn't be here. He wouldn't be here. So we have to learn how to work through these things. Because the key thing is we're at a different place on the continuum. We're on a journey. And our understandings are different. And we are called to love one another and to help one another to come to that place of understanding and enlightenment. And the final thing is that we're not the judge. We must leave others to God and live in the light as we understand it, that hopefully they may come to that light one day. And if the light is right and they're seeking the Lord, they will come to that place. So let's come to God in prayer. God of glory, we exalt your name. This morning as we've come aside, we've set aside this time to reflect on old hymns and songs that have meant something to us and we haven't sung for a while. But we thank you that you're the same God yesterday, today, and forever. And we want to begin by thanking you for some of our four believers whose faith, as it were, Lord, out of whose faith some of these songs and hymns were hacked, and we can experience something of the depth of their relationship with you. And when we sing these words, it connects us with you. We want to thank you for the reality of their faith. But we know, Father, there are many, many new believers in our time that you're speaking through and bringing wonderful words of life to all of us. We pray that together this morning as we worship you, you might remind us of promises you have made to us, that you might remind us of your call upon our lives to go in certain direction, of your promises to us to be faithful, to use us, Help us to know, Father, that it is important when we hear the word that we have to get up from where we are and move towards you to allow you to accomplish the things you want to accomplish. So we thank you for the gathered community, for those who are joining us online. Holy Spirit, you are so amazing that absolutely nothing can separate us from God and from each other. We pray that this morning together, as we bring praise and thanksgiving to the Almighty, that He will sense something of the joy in our hearts and our faith, believing that nothing is too difficult and that, Father, you will do great things among us. So we give ourselves to you, asking for your cleansing and your renewal and your enabling power, so that together, as we sing, as we pray, as we reflect, we will sense something of the joy of the Lord. Break down any barriers, Lord. Heal wounds. Open eyes to see you. And let our own hearts be a river of your joy as it flow out to each other. For we ask all these things for your glory and your kingdom's sake. Amen. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. Just say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And help us not to fall into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. If some of you are still struggling with the idea of my changing the Lord's Prayer slightly from lead us not into temptation, the Bible clearly tells us that God does not lead us into temptation, nor does he tempt us. So to say, help us not to fall, the devil tempts us. So help us not to fall into it when the devil tempts us. You know, just bless the Lord. You know, last week I was blessed to see Dixie coming back, and here he is today. You know, and to hear his testimony and Franklin's testimony, and my sisters and brothers, I want to tell you something. In the seeming ordinary, God is doing extraordinary things, and it is important for us to reach out to him in the seemingly ordinary things and ask him to intervene, and he will do amazing things. And when you feel overwhelmed and challenged, just bring it to God and say, Lord, help me with this. Help me so that I might be the person you want to be. Brother Scott, it's good to see you here this morning. We pray that, you know, you'll be blessed here in this time. You know, he's not able to get out as much, but it's good to see him. And for those who have been away, we welcome you and pray that God will bless you and that you'll be a blessing to us as we worship him together. We want to sing a hymn, or rather, not to me, some old-time, you know, melody songs as we say good morning. And let it be a time of saying good morning and bless you as we sing these songs together. Please come and lead us. The Caribbean medley we're going to sing. Let's stand and say good morning to each other. The Lord.
Yeah, good morning, church.
Good morning.
The reading is taken from Psalms 150, verse 1 to 6. Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty firmament. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the lute and the harp. Praise him with the tremble and dance. Praise him with the stringed and instruments and flutes. Praise him with loud cymbals. Praise him with clashing cymbals. Let everything that we breathe praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Morning, church. Good morning. Morning and welcome to City Road Baptist Church. Welcome to our praise and worship service, as Pastor has explained. Time, old songs that, you know, some of us remember. So welcome. If you're online or in the sanctuary, we just welcome you and we pray that you will be blessed by this morning's service. Okay. The Psalms is saying, Psalm 141, praise the Lord. How good is it to sing praises to our God? How pleasant and fitting to praise him. So we give him praise and thanks. We welcome our first time visitors to us today. Manuel and Abigail's, Abigail's brother, who, you know, asked us to pray for in the past. So welcome. And also their cousin, welcome. And we pray, you know, God will continue to minister to you. Mr. Scott, pastors already welcome you. It's good to see you again in the congregation. Welcome.
It's okay.
Welcome, Joy. She's right on cue. Some people just, you know, right, like this morning when Pastor walked in, I thought, okay. Oh, gosh, yes. Yes, but you're here. You've won the battle. You've already won it. You've got the victory. So thanks, you know, for you, everyone being here. And for those who've been unwell, we know, you know, Dixie was with us, and there are others who have returned who've been unwell. You know, we just give God thanks and praise. Please also remember our sister Valda, who's in hospital, and our sister Mrs. Fawkes as well. So please remember them as well, you know, prayer. Just to give thanks and praise for everybody who supported. I want to say a special thank you to Sean, was, you know, for all your support during the week. You know, things were happening behind the scene that people were not aware of. So just thank you, Sean, for that support. And also yesterday, you know, I did ask for people to step forward, and I must admit, thank you all those who came yesterday and made the work so light for everyone. Thank you very much. Welcome you back, Pastor Gordon. And, you know, we just give God thanks and praise that you and Sister Maxine came back safely. And we delay, yes, but, you know, God is in the midst of everything. And you got your back safely when you're here this morning. Okay. Housekeeping, please, if you haven't already done so, can you please turn your mobile off or put it on silence? Also, toilets are through the door on my right. Tithes and offering, if you want to give electronically, please go to the church's website. You'll find the church's detail. Fire alarm, if it does go off, you will be escorted by the safest route from the sanctuary. Okay. And I hope everyone has got a copy of our notice sheet. As I say, there are a lot of activities on it that we're doing because it's our anniversary. Coffee morning on the 20th of September, and 27th, we've also got the Macmillan. 1st of October, please, our harvest service. Can somebody please, you know, I have asked people to step forward. And the 7th of October, we have our harvest celebration. The tickets are now available, and as far as I know, it's Ruth Marriott who's got the tickets. So please, tickets for the 7th of October are now available from Ruth Marriott, okay? Adults, £6, and children, £3, okay? And regarding Bible study and home group this week, Les Marie's and Pastor Gordon's home group and Bible study, those are not on this week, okay? But they'll be recommenced next week. The others are as usual. And I think because we've got the diabetic talk on Wednesday evening. Okay. And Pastor's already mentioned Maxine's dad's funeral, so please remember that. Okay. And the prayer, please. You know, as I say, a lot of prayer. And Deacon's election, please continue to pray and just listen to what the Lord is saying to you. Sometimes you think, I can't be there, but remember Job. not Job, remember Job, what's his name, who wanted to not to do what God called him to. Yes, thank you. Yeah, we're always running away. Jonah tried to run away, but remember, he'll bring you back.
And so you can sing, Jesus is tenderly calling today, calling you guys. Okay, let's bring our tithes and our offerings to the Lord. Ah, we didn't select a song to sing, did we? Yep, okay, yes, good, great, go. Yes. Faithful one, yes. Okay, thank you.
Protect us. Continue to pray for those who are loved to be here but unable to do so for different reasons. You've given so much to us, dear Father. We bring back just a small portion for to be used for the continuing of your work. All these things we ask in your precious and holy name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you so much. See a show of your hands if you have experienced the faithfulness of God, His provision. And if you haven't, then maybe you need to put Him to the test and ask Him for something, and you'll be amazed what God will do. Because you know, my sisters and my brothers, it's important that we are able individually to say that I know that God is able, and God has done this for me. We need to be able to bring that real testimony that I know that God has done this for me. Right. We're going to look at the memory verse for today, and then we're going to sing three old hymns. And after we have sung these hymns, I want to ask you maybe for your reflection in those hymns. And maybe there may be a hymn that we haven't got listed that you maybe want to say something about, and even possibly maybe want to sing it to us that we don't know. So this is it's going to be a great time of worshiping together. So who can remember what the memory verse is for today? Our memory verse is, oh, Wendy was straight up there. Bang, I know. Anyone else apart from Wendy? Or are you too shy? And also Diane. Okay, so she remembers where it's from, so that's 1 point. 1 point, anybody else? All right, okay, Wendy, so tell us what it is, Wendy, so we can hear.
It's Daniel 3, chapter 3, verse 17 and 16.
Yeah.
And I'm quoting it, 17 and 18, sorry, and I'm quoting from NKJV. And if that is the case, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us from your hand, O King. Yeah. But if not, let it be known to you, O King, that we will not serve your gods, and neither will we worship the gold image that you have set up. Amen.
Well, Wendy, I'm going to give you two pens. And you can share it with somebody else. Share it with somebody else. You know, the interesting thing in particular about that verse was the saying now, it says, I know that my God will deliver us. But said, but even if he choose not to deliver us, let it be known. Let it be known. And that's the kind of confidence we need to have in God, and also the preparedness that if God choose to take us through that fire and take us home, then that is choice. But he is able to demonstrate, let me say to you, sisters and brothers, God is looking for boys and girls, women and men who are prepared to stand their ground for him. Because it is only when we stand our ground that the world will truly see who God really is. Let's have it up on the screen, Ruth, and let's say it together. Now, you see, whenever you are put in that place, you know, sometimes you may be asked to do something, and you know that that's just not what you want. I said, well, if you don't want to do it, well, sorry, you don't have a job. What do you do? What do you do? So let's say it together. If we are thrown into the blazing furnace, the God we serve is able to deliver us from it, and he will deliver us from your majesty's hand. But even if he does not, we want you to know, your majesty, that we will not serve your gods or worship the image of gold you have set up. But isn't it also interesting that they didn't disrespect him? They said they recognize his area, but it says but our God has a greater area. And we will not serve your God. Man. How many of you know the hymn? I lift my hands to the coming King, to the great I am, to you I sing, for you're the one who reigns within. My heart, I lift my hands. I lift my hands to the coming King, to the great I am, to you I sing, for you're the one who reigns within my heart, and I will serve no foreign God. Serve no foreign God. And the memory verse for next week is Psalm 150 in verse 6. Let's just say this together. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You know, Maxine was reminding me, was telling someone about a neighbor we had. He moved away about 20, goodness me, maybe about nearly 30 years. He's moved away from where we lived. And he said if there's one thing he won't miss, was my singing coming through the walls in the Sunday morning. But we're still friends, you know. We're still friends. Yeah. You know, he says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Now, next Sunday, I want all of you to know this. So I want you to practice this. Praise the Lord with dancing, with singing. You know, let the joy of the Lord just fill you this coming week. All right. I'm going to ask the group to come now, and we're going to sing three hymns, old hymns. One to begin, Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah, followed by Jesus, Keep Me Near the Cross. How many of you know these hymns? If you know these hymns, as I speak them out, put your hand up. How many of you know Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah? Okay, what about Jesus, Keep Me Near the Cross? Fewer people? Okay, what about Sing Them Over Again to Me, Wonderful Words of Life? Okay, these are the three hymns we're going to sing together. And then I want to hear your reflections. And maybe even as we sing them, they may bring back fresh memories to you. Okay. Are we good? All right, let's give it a go. And those of you who are joining us at home, maybe you will just sing your hearts out. Let the neighbors hear you sing it. All right? Let's stand together.
Oh, happy with this
okay,
one.
Okay,
Jesus, keep me near the cross. Hallelujah. Yeah. Near precious fountain.
Jesus, keep me near the cross. Beautiful words.
Let's take this moment to reflect, just for a few moments. During the singing of these songs, did it bring back any special memories to anyone? Anyone that would like to, Joy, you want to come and share what that was? Yes? Come on then. For those of you who don't know, Joy's my sister.
You would have to say that. Morning, everyone. Yeah. The first song, it brought me straight back to my senior school back in the 60s. We had this huge teacher she was very religious. And whenever we were singing that song, she'll had us all in certain rows, and who's going to say, "Strong deliverers," and you all had to, whew. And it just sort of zapped me straight back into that classroom when we were practicing, and we had to go in the hall, massive hall, because I went to this school in King's Standing. That school was chosen by the educational department, because children in the early 60s, mid 60s, coming into the country, over 11, they offered our parents free dinners, bus fares to go out of the area. So I had to travel from Handsworth to King's Standing every day. On a few occasions, my father used to sneak me in the GPO van and drop me off on top of King's Standing Road, where I'd jump under 33, that was if I was running late. But yeah, that song was one of the memories. And then I used to hear my mum singing it as well, so it brings fond memories. So I didn't even think of it because I think it brings back not good memories, it's kind of bittersweet. But some of the memories is good, because this woman, when she sang, the one day her blouse just poof, and the buttons and the girls were scrambling around, because it was like a girls' school up until fourth year. They call that year 10 now, something like that. So it was up until fourth year, then they amalgamated us with the boys. Yeah, but then by then I was chucked out of certain cooking lessons and that. And I had to do woodwork because I was a naughty girl, yeah. Yeah, yeah, thank you.
Yes, yes.
Just to make an analogy. Yeah, right. Because, you know, we're singing old songs. Old songs. So old songs would assume that they're not relevant for today. That's how I interpret it. If you say it's an old song, like "I saddled on my horse on a ride into town," you don't saddle on your horse and you ride into town. You drive into town because we have cars, or you catch a bus. So that's an old song, isn't it? Does that make sense? I'm giving an analogy. That's an old song because we don't ride horses anymore, and you know, we drive cars. But what I'm saying about these hymns are timeless. And I'm going to give you three timeless analogies. One is "A Stitch in Time Saves Nine." That's an old analogy, and it still stands now. If you don't deal with something right now, you'll have a whole mess to deal with, you know, later on. "A Stitch in Time Saves Nine." Years old, back into the like fourth century or whatever it is. If you go to the doctor's and you have a wound, he'll say to you, "You're going to need to deal with that, otherwise it'll get worse and it might fester. You might get sepsis and die." That still rings true. If you don't deal with it now, it'll fester and go wrong. And the third one from the Bible, it says, "Seek the Lord while he may be found." That's an old adage. It's old. He says, and there's something that springs to mind. It says that while I'm here and while you're alive and in sound mind, seek me. Seek me in your youth, when you're not busy with bills and things that tie you down, because that will be the best time of your life. When you have Christ in your life and your youth, your whole future is sorted, because all those things that are here would ingrain in you in when you're a youth will come to fruition in times of trouble. So when the storm does come in times of trouble, he will be faithful, and he'll be faithful as he was in the beginning, as he will be in the end, so long as you hold on to the promises that he sows in you from old. Does that make sense? I had to make that analogy. We're not singing old songs. We're singing new songs to bring the word of God and to make sure that it's true today. Amen.
And that's the word for today. Now, you hold on to those three things, you know, that Fitzroy shared with us. You don't need any more. And as we sing the hymns, let that kind of, you know, just marinate in your hearts and recognize the importance of things. But coming back to the hymns before we go move on to another section, we're going to, after we have sung these songs, I wonder, let me ask, is there anyone, a special hymn that is really burning in your heart that you'd like to come and sing to us? You're pointing a finger at who? Bill. Bill, you have a hymn you want to sing to us. Okay, in a moment, I'll call you to come and sing it. Okay? Right. You know, it's good to see these young men coming forward, you know, and so eager. It's wonderful. Yeah, it's wonderful. What about some of the other hymns that we've sung? Anything it's brought back to your memory? Anyone want to come and share something? All right. Whilst you're thinking, Bill, come and sing to us. Yes. What is the hymn you want to sing to us? All right. Well, if I know it, I can do that. Yes. Just like I didn't know I was going to preach, I didn't know I was going to sing this song. You know.
450.
What hymn is it?
Good off. Is it afternoon or morning?
It's morning. Afternoon.
It's afternoon. No.
450.
Good afternoon.
Yeah. 450.
Yes, it's 450.
Okay, what is it?
I was sinking deep in sin.
Yes, I was sinking deep in sin.
You'll sing with me.
Yes, okay.
All right, okay.
I was sinking
I was sinking deep in sin.
Sinking to rise no more.
Okay, go for one more verse.
Soul in danger, Lord, come on. Jesus, come in me, say. He will live in wise love, out of the hungry way.
He's the master of the sea. He loves it, will obey. He's your
think of a verse of scripture that maybe you could connect that song to. Just the chorus, Love Lifted Me. Any verse of scripture? Renew their strength, yes. Mm-hmm. Anything else? Okay. You want to come and sing that to us? Come on, Bev. Come and bless us. Bev, come on. Come on. Come and sing that to us, Bev. Come on, Bev. Sing that to us. Yeah.
Because your love is better than life. With my lips, I will glorify you. I will love you as long as I live. With your name, I lift my hands. Because your love,
Psalm 63.
Okay, we're going to move on now to sing three more songs and hymns, and then we're going to spend a little time in prayer, and then we're going to sing one song. And as I said to you, you know, Fitzroy has already spoken the word, but I just want to share a few thoughts, and then we move straight on. Okay, so we're going to sing three more hymns. Can I ask the group to come now, please? Yes. He's got the whole world in his hand, and tempted and tried. And I know not why God's wondrous love. Okay. Let's. You have to stand for this one, then you can sit for the next one. The group to sing the next song. Just listen to this song, Tempted and Tried. Okay? That's it. Tempted and Tried. little time in prayer. Who's leading us today in prayer? Please come, Sylvia.
Good afternoon, brethren. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Almighty and ever-loving Father, we thank you for this privilege of coming before you as a congregation to honor you, to sing praises to your name, to remember others who have gone on before us, who have testified through songs your faithfulness to them. So we thank you for them. We thank you that they have been kept for us to know, to sing, to lift us up as we go along. Almighty Father, yes, we agree. These are times when they're hard. We don't quite understand. We don't quite understand how to live sometimes when things come at us in such great difficulty. But we're asking you, because you are our Father, and you said we should come to you and ask you. We're asking you to draw us to the scriptures so that we can see and understand as you show us through your word by your Holy Spirit, so that we can live and move in times like these. Help us to be like the sons of Issachar in the scriptures, who understood the times and know what they should do. Help us to be that way, because we're searching the scriptures. We're knowing what the word said, and we're also having you as our guide to show us what to do. Father, help us not to despair in these trying, testing times, but lift up our hearts to you, because you are the God who gives us strength. And as the song said, farther along, we'll know all about it. We'll understand why. As we get farther along in the scriptures and you show us your plan for us and the great future which you have in store for us, if we endure to the end, it tells us that you have a crown of life awaiting us. So we look forward to that. We look forward to it with joyful hearts, with cheer, without despair. We thank you and we praise you that every good gift, every perfect and precious gift to us come down from heaven. And we are grateful. You are the God who sustains us. You uphold us. You strengthen us. When we get into difficulty, you call us, come to me. All you who are heavily burdened, who are distressed, I will give you rest. Take my yoke on you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly, and in me you will find rest for your souls, because my yoke is easy and my burden is light. So give us the courage to yoke up with our Savior. Know that he will take the strain. So we give you all the glory. We remember our sister Pam, who is going into the hospital, and remember those of us who are in hospital at this time. We lift them up to you, Father, and we ask you for strength for them. Hallelujah. We ask you, O God, to strengthen them and to remind us to keep them lifted up in praise. So we thank you, Lord, for the opportunity to come before you as a congregation, to lift you up in song, in worship, in praise. Thank you for the scriptures that encourage us to sing and dance, Psalm 150. We thank you for it, Father. It lifts us up and it cheers us. So we thank you this morning. We bless you as a congregation and ask you to remember all the congregations around the world who are worshiping you today, this morning. Lift them up, Lord. Cheer the sick. Just help those who are oppressed in any way. Strengthen them as only you can. So we give you the praise and thank you in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen, Lord. Amen. Amen.
Day at a time, sweet Jesus. as the prayer was just saying, that we need to come to him daily, as we do anyway, as we should do. But that's where we'll find, you know, our strength to take each step a day at a time. Amen.
Finishing in 7 minutes' time, and we have two songs to sing in that time, so you can just see how short my sermon is going to be this morning. Well, Fitzroy's already brought the word. When I said that was the word for today, I was serious about that. But I just want to highlight Psalm 150. We began by singing "To God Be the Glory." I want to encourage you to find something every day to thank God for. It doesn't matter what's going on around you, look for something to give God thanks for. It says, great things he has done. We sang Love Lifted Me, and that hymn says, so loved the world that he gave us his son, that through Jesus Christ we may have life. And in Christ, we have the ability not only to experience why we were created, but to become so amazingly wonderful in the hand of God and the sight of God. The gifts that God has given to you, he has given to you not only for your family, but for the greater family. So the psalmist has outlined ways in which we can praise God. Because let me say to you, oftentimes you wake up in the morning with things on your mind that make you don't want to praise, not even want to get out of bed. But let me ask you the question, if you're having a headache or a toothache, what do you do? And Fitzroy is saying that he's having a fag, is he? What is he saying he's doing? He's taking some painkillers. Well, let me tell you, praising God is the greatest anesthetic that you can take for all the things that's going on. It doesn't matter where you find yourself, even when you cannot speak the words, even if you're just humming it, and it begins to lift you and to lift you until you can praise God. So remember, my brothers and my sisters, it says, praise God in his sanctuary. That's where God lives. Where does God live? He lives in us. So you don't have to wait until we gather together. Praise God wherever you are, because God is in you. So look around you and thank God. Thank God that you woke up this morning. Thank God that you can make yourself a cup of tea. Don't focus on the negative. I want to leave this thought with you. Some of us have a variety of bank accounts, but in terms of our spiritual life, there are two accounts that we need to have. Or rather, just one account. The one where we keep all the good, positive deposits, the good things that God has done. And we need to clear out that account where we keep all the negative things we have experienced. Because you know something? When you have that account with the negativities, that's where you go all the time to draw. And the moment you say to your teller, now give me something negative happened to you, it brings all the negative things out to you. And you know what it does? It ruins your life. But the moment you start to praise God, it brings another song and another song. And it reminds you of the goodness of God and what he's done for you. And before you know it, you feel rich and you're walking out and you think, you know what? It's going to be an amazing day. But if you keep taking out of that negative bank, oh, you remember when so-and-so did that, and you did that, and then you begin to see everything through that, and then before you know it, your day is over. Your day is over. So if you want to live a full life, learn how to clear out that negative account, even though they may be true. Clear it out, because every time you go there, you know what you do? It becomes bigger. Interest grows on it. Every time you remember a negative thing, it becomes bigger. But when you start praising God, it diminishes those things and you begin to grow. It says, praise him in his sanctuary and praise him in his mighty heavens. So when you walk out, sometimes you see folks walking down the street and they're laughing and you think, is he okay? But they're talking to somebody on their phones, but you don't realize it's what they're doing. Now talk to your God. I don't care if people want to think you're crazy. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Look around and say, Lord, you're amazing. But don't go around all the time looking as though you're crazy. Be sensible as well. So you can have good conversation with people. Praise him for what he has done, because it makes it tangible. That is why I said earlier, it's important for us to be able to earth our relationship in real things. That I know that God has done this for me. And so I can say, I can thank you for this. It's important that we have those real things. So you said, praise him for his acts of power. You look around the world, you see what God has done. You know, whatever instrument, whether it's you can play musical instrument, just your hands or your voice or dancing, just praise God. Remember when David was dancing before the Lord because he was so full of joy? David was the king. And his wife thought, you're making a fool of yourself. But David didn't care because there was a joy in his heart. Don't allow the views of others to contain you. Let the joy of the Lord fill you and praise God. and hope that they too will join you in praising God. My sisters and my brothers, I want to leave that with you this morning, that when we lift God up, because we have a choice. Remember in John 14, when Jesus was about to leave his disciples, he says, now, do not allow your hearts to be troubled. You hear that? Do not allow your hearts to be troubled. If we didn't have the ability to stop ourselves from worrying, God would not have said that to us. He gives us the power. The moment you start walking down that road of worry, say, hey, no, I'm going to step back and I'm going to go down the road of praise. He says, trust in God. You believe in God, believe also in me. And that's the word. Can you remember what Fitzroy said? Can anyone remember what Fitzroy said earlier? A stitch in time saves. When something needs to attend to it. If you go down to the doctor, men in particular, men, if you have an issue, go to the doctor. Because oftentimes we don't go, we don't even go. We think, oh, it's going to be all right. And what was the third thing? What was the third thing that Fitzroy said? Seek the Lord while he may be found. Meaning, whilst you have the capacity and the ability to seek the Lord, seek the Lord. So you do not live in regret. Seek the Lord while he may be found. And it is there you will find the joy of the Lord, my sisters and my brothers. And in order for us to receive the benefits of these things, we have to literally take them on board. So may God take his word, read Psalm 150 again, reflect in what Fitzroy has said, and allow the grace of God to fill your heart and to draw you closer to him. We're going to sing two final songs. We're going to sing Amazing Grace, My Chains Fell Off, and then we're going to bless each other, and then we're going to go and have some food. Okay? So let's stand together as we sing Amazing Grace.
Grace that drove my heart.
And so, Father, we ask that as we go from this time of gathering, as we have fellowship around food and some of us have to go home, may your Spirit go with us. As we impart the blessing to each other, may you be present and may it be tangible so we know that not only have you heard, but you are responding to our requests. We ask these things for your glory and your kingdom's sake. Amen. The blessing. Let's sing to each other. The Lord bless you.
to your name. So worthy, Lord. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.